This is the Good Neighbor Podcast, the place where local businesses and neighbors come together. Here's your host, Cabo Jim Schaller.
Welcome, Good Neighbors, episode number 93 of the Good Neighbor Podcast, Estero. Today we have Good Neighbor Alex King from New American Funding. Alex, welcome.
Hi, thank you so much for having me.
Yes, I'm excited to get to know about what you do and to learn a little bit more about you.
Awesome. Excited to be here.
Yes. Why don't we jump right in and why don't you share a little bit about what you do over at New American Funding?
I would love to. So I am a mortgage loan originator, also known as a mortgage loan officer. I am with a group called the Be Your Gift Group, and we are powered by New American Funding. So yeah, we handle all residential lending that you can think of.
Wow. Now, how did you get involved in that industry?
Funny story, actually. I actually am a forensic scientist by trade. So I went to school. So I went to school for forensics and actually worked in the industry for over 6.5 years.
Wow.
But you learn a lot about yourself as you grow and, become an adult.
Right.
And I just knew that that was not my end all be all. And I had an opportunity to step into the mortgage industry. My mentor and my branch manager, Giovanni Matita, basically, I don't want to say poached me, but, you know, he had given me an opportunity and he slowed down with me and explained from start to finish, you know, what mortgages were and why he thought I would be a great loan officer assistant.
Right.
And, you know, it took a year of us talking before I finally decided to come on board. But I think what really was the catalyst for me, after learning about the industry, I actually ended up buying my own home through a builder, which I will not name who, obviously. But I was obviously still in the forensics industry at the time, but kind of on my way out. And it was not a great experience. It was very stressful. It was hard to get a hold of people. It was, you're approved, you're not, you're approved, you're not. And I was just very confused as to how you can tell someone they can have the house and then revoke it the next day.
Right? Wow.
So I vowed that when I stepped into this industry, after leaving the forensics industry, that I was going to make a difference and be the person I needed that loan officer to be for me when I was buying my first home.
I love it. I love it. So you traded CSI in for mortgage help, right?
You know, I get the, how, I'm like, why did you leave? I don't get it. And it's like, listen, CSI is, I would, if it was like CSI, then I probably would have stayed forever. But I will tell you, it is not.
No.
It is not glitz and glamour. It is windowless buildings and not people who are excited to be at work. We'll just leave it there.
Right. It's not all as glamorous as we see on TV, right?
No, it's not.
So we've all been through some type of, I want to say, hardship or challenge along our journey. Is there something that maybe you went through that you can look back at now and say, you know what, that kind of helped me?
Absolutely. I mean, I kind of feel like this question is like a twofold for me, because when I did leave the forensics industry, I was supervising. So when I took this job as Giovanni's assistant, I took a huge pay cut, like a 50% pay cut. And for me, obviously, I think for anybody, that's a large pay cut, especially with living in Southwest Florida. It's not cheap. Obviously, I was going to get paid some commissions and things like that, but I didn't know where that money was coming from. So leaving a salary job to enter a commission-based job was terrifying. But I will tell you that each small step I took along the way, which, you know, learning from Giovanni, he taught me everything that I honestly know today, exposed me to so many different files and so many different loan scenarios. And then taking that mortgage test myself to then becoming, you know, a hybrid position where I was working with my own clients, but also still assisting, kind of, you know, taught me that with hard work and a lot of faith that you truly can do anything. And I will say the last piece of that for me is I went through a breakup with my ex-fiance during, you know, I was working in this industry. Yep. And obviously when you lose the household income, things shift again. And so I was finally getting the hang of things. And then I obviously had this trial thrown at me, which was the biggest blessing there ever was, because it saved me from a divorce in the future. Let's be honest.
Yep.
When someone's not for you, they're not for you.
But
I truly, in that time frame, I leaned into my relationship with God, my faith. And then I truly worked on my inner healing. And in that, I found the pieces of myself that were broken and that didn't believe in myself and just didn't think that I was good enough to deserve better. And I think when I found that personally, I found that professionally as well. And in the next year and a half after that, I took a full-fledged step into becoming a full-time loan officer. So I bet myself. But, you know, looking back, all of those pieces of the puzzle had to happen in order for me to be able to grow and heal and learn and become the person I needed to be to step into the role of, hey, I trust myself enough to know I can do this. I have the backing. I have my team, you know, and I know that I'm going to figure it out at the end of the day because I have God on my side leading the way.
Absolutely. See, it's that old adage, don't regret anything that happened in your past because it's made you bigger, better, and stronger for where you are today. And you're in a better place today. And that's what it's all about.
No, I mean, I'm in a wonderful place today. I couldn't, you know, I look back sometimes and I'm like, wow, I remember those moments and I remember how hard and how scary it was. But looking at where I am today, happily married, like we're having a baby in September, you know, I found my person, like we're starting a family, business is booming. There's a lot of things that I would never have had if I didn't take those steps and I didn't walk through what I walked through. So
I love it. I love it. So are you from down here originally?
I'm not. I am born You're and raised not? In New Hampshire.
Wow. What brought you down to Southwest Florida?
So when I graduated from college, I had no job offers lined up. I knew there was a huge lab system in forensics down here. And my mom had actually moved down when I was a senior in college. So she asked if I wanted to come down, check it out, try it out. I said, I guess I got nothing going on up here. Right. I don't want to live in my hometown forever. Mm-hmm. Let's go. So I literally packed up my my Ford Focus.
Wow.
With everything I could, everything else right. I left behind. And I moved to Florida at the age of 21. Fort Myers. Mm-hmm.
Love it. And you haven't looked back.
No. I've gone back up to visit, but every time I'm here, I'm just reminded of like the beautiful life that I've built down here, the friendships, the business relationships. And I mean, it's paradise. It's so hard to leave here, in my opinion. I mean, I know not everyone agrees, but
I love it. I know your job is very demanding, but what do you enjoy doing outside of work?
Well, when I'm not working, I go to Next Level Church. So I'm involved in my church and every Sunday I serve and then I attend. And for me, you know, it's a way to fill back up my cup. I love just being around other believers and, you know, just being surrounded by such great people. Obviously I love my husband and my family. They're all in, you know, my mom's side is in this area. Yep. So, I enjoy spending time with them and I am in love. I'm an avid baker. I very much enjoy
cooking.
My specialty is cheesecakes. So I've perfected the science of cheesecake. So I'm the
official baker. Have you gotten the key lime cheesecake down yet?
I haven't tried that one yet, but I bet you I could do it.
Yeah.
I'll have to send one to you.
Absolutely. I love cheesecake. Love it. So on the business side of things, are there any maybe myths or maybe misconceptions about, you know, the mortgage loan industry that we could clear up for our listeners?
You know, I was thinking about this question because I do think the industry in general has a, I think there's a sense of mistrust that follows this industry. And I say that because I know so many people that have had really bad experiences, but I also chalk it up to the fact that you are purchasing a home. That's one of the largest financial decisions you will ever make. And if you're already not comfortable with your realtor and you're not comfortable with your loan officer, entering a process like that with someone you're not 100% comfortable with is already a recipe for disaster. And so I do tell people like the way that our company, how, you know, our team runs business and me personally, I want to get to know you as a human being first. I want to connect with you. I want to learn about you. Like, what is it that you're trying to do? Like, what are your goals? Okay. So this is what we want. it's doable, it's not doable, and we put together a plan. You know, those conversations happen up front because I want them to know I see them as a person and not just a transaction. So I want to change that in the industry. I want people to know not every loan officer is the same. Not, I mean, yes, there are bad apples everywhere, you know, but there are a lot of good people down here that do a lot of good work. It's not just about the money. It's truly about helping those understand the process from start to finish, taking that time, you know, to slow down and making sure they have all their questions answered. That's important to me. And the other misconception that I've just seen, you know, obviously with the conversation of rate, this wasn't a misconception, you know, back in 2020, 2021, when we had the 3.5%, but, you know, I just think that people are so focused on rate that they are missing the bigger picture of it matters who you work with. Just because that's the cheapest option doesn't mean that that's the best option for you. You could honestly be signing yourself up for a horrible experience just because you're chasing a 6% rate from someone. So it's just, you know, encouraging people to actually have the conversations with their loan officers to make sure they're comfortable. Make sure they're not going to have any issues working with this person. You know, I think that's bottom line that's missed a lot in this industry, quite honestly.
Perfect. Yeah, it's providing that customer service on your end that lacks so much today.
People
yearn for. So appreciate you and thank you for doing that. Is there one last thing maybe that our listeners should know about what you do that maybe they don't know?
I think what a lot of people don't know is that they don't know what they don't know. And so I think it's important that if you're looking to buy, to actually have a conversation with a professional in the industry, even if you're not ready, because we can actually have a conversation. Maybe we work on your credit and then we put a plan together for, hey, this is what we're going to have to do to get you to the place that you need to be to purchase the home that you want. I just think that many people listen to others that are not in the industry that give them not very great advice. So I would truly advise you to speak to somebody, whether, you know, it doesn't have to be me, but speak to a loan officer, put together a plan if you're really looking to buy in the next year, because we really can expedite the process for you and explain everything that you don't know or that you might be questioning to get you to where you want to be faster.
Very good. And that's the goal, to get people where they want to be.
Exactly.
So how would our listeners go about getting a hold of you if they had questions or they're looking to get into a new home?
So, I mean, I am the easiest to get a hold of by a phone call or a text message for sure. So my cell phone number would be the easiest. Am I allowed to share that here? Yes.
Yeah. I'll put it at the bottom as well too. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
And then I'll give you my email as well, because I'm constantly checking emails and on my phone. So my cell phone is 603-809-9474. And then email is alex.king@nancyafrankinc.com.
Perfect. Alex, it's been a pleasure getting to know you. Thank you for being such a good neighbor. And I hope to see you out in the community here soon.
Oh, you will for sure. Thank you so much for having me. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you for listening to the Good Neighbor Podcast, Estero. To nominate your favorite local businesses to be featured on the show, go to gnpestero.com. That's gnpestero.com. Or call 239-296-2621.